In fact, you would have passed that mock test.
Wow. Wow.
Wow.
Okay, really? So yeah. Hi guys, welcome back to Drive London. I'm Rohit, this is Viktor.
Yeah.
We're about to do a mock test for you. Viktor has his test coming up soon. He found us from YouTube as well. Watched some of our
videos. Yeah, they are very useful. So yeah.
Thank you. Now, we have done a couple of mock tests before, but this is one now just before his actual test. And this is the last lesson he's got before his test as well. So
yeah.
Hopefully he passes this mock test. I've got high expectations. I feel like he's got a good drive in him. Now, he does have some experience from before.
Yeah. So in other side of the road in Europe.
Okay.
So actually that's why I decided to go here and to learn how to drive in the UK.
Yeah. So it used to be a left-hand drive on the other side of the road. So he has experience from that. Now it is difficult to kind of change over sometimes. We did about 20 hours. And I feel like he's ready. And the main thing is just kind of dealing with the gear changes, knowing where to position and the kind of roundabouts.
And checking the mirrors.
And the mirrors as well. Okay, good. So we're going to get into this mock test. Just to explain how it's going to work again, it's going to last for 40 minutes. During those 40 minutes, we're going to keep from the road ahead unless asked to turn left or right. There'll be one maneuver, possibly the emergency stop, and one show me and one tell me question.
Yep.
Okay? For you guys, whenever Viktor makes any mistakes, any serious or dangerous mistakes will be up in red here. Any minors, anything advisory, will be in amber. And anything that he does good, anything well, in green. Okay? All right, good. Should we get started?
Yeah.
Okay, so before we go, could you tell me how we would check the tire pressure and where would you find the information?
So we can check the tire pressure by using the tool, the gauge tool, just to put it into the wheel, and we can find the information on the manual to the car or on the driver pillar or on the driver door. It should be a label with all the pressures.
Thank you. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to follow my directions and we're going to do some independent driving following some signs later on.
Okay.
I'll tell you when these are going to start. I might start them while we are driving as well, but I'll let you know in good time.
Whenever
you're ready, I'd like us to move off.
Good.
Take the next road on your right. next roundabout. Drive on again whenever you're ready. Close to his car in front, okay?
Okay.
Leave yourself about a car's distance away just to get a bit closer. Mm-hmm. A little bit closer. And that's great, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
And drive on whenever you're ready again.
Okay.
Thank you. left, first exit the roundabout. To turn right, I like us to follow signs to Staines.
Staines.
I suppose. right of the traffic lights. So you're going to follow my directions now, okay? Okay, thank you. And now I'd like us to reverse back two car lengths, keeping reasonably close with the curb.
Okay? Mm-hmm. Okay.
And you may start whenever you're ready.
Okay.
Okay, thank you. We're going to drive on whenever you're ready. So rejoin the road when it's safe. Okay, thank you. And we're gonna drive on one of you already.
It's not a curve.
Give me a second.
Yeah, I think I failed it. Maybe with two mistakes.
Okay, why do you reckon you failed?
So I think that the second set of directions that you gave me about following to can't remember the
city. Was Witten? Yes.
Witten. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So there was like a roundabout.
Yeah.
And I think that was line discipline there in the middle of the roundabout.
Yeah, it wasn't the greatest. Because you started moving over to your left and then
you moved
back to your right and then back to your left.
Yeah, but no one was behind me.
Correct.
And
I feel like you were checking your mirrors at the same time as doing all of this. So I didn't give you a serious mistake there. I give you a minor.
Okay.
Because you were checking your mirrors and you was doing it safely and there was no one around us.
Yeah, yeah.
you walked away with a minor there, but it could be very easily a serious mistake if there's an overcarner.
If behind
correct
someone.
Yeah, and, you just got to make sure we keep to one lane, and then when you get to the second exit, that we drift back to the left signal and take the exit, as long as it's safe to do so.
Yeah.
And on that occasion, there was no cars on our left. There was no reason why we couldn't have moved to the left. Mm-hmm. The reason why you did all of that, I felt, is because you're going a bit too fast. As you went round the roundabout.
On the roundabout.
Correct. As you're going round the roundabout, you're in third gear.
Yeah, it was the green line. I saw the green line. I was on the short. I think during the entering, I switched to the second one. And I stayed on the second one.
I'm not sure. I think you stayed in third.
No, I definitely remember that
you
gave
me
the sign. And I was following in the third gear.
Mm-hmm.
I saw the green line. And I was skipping a bit on the third gear, just to not to, you know, to slow down much more because I think behind me was, or maybe no one was behind me.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then I switched to the second one.
Okay, maybe we switched to second gear
as
well.
But
it was still too fast.
Yeah, maybe.
You're not giving yourself time to be able to check your mirrors properly and be able to make that judgment if you can move back to your left. Hence why you do I not? And then you just kind of stayed in
there. Yeah. I was actually confused with this island with the chevrons.
Yeah.
In the middle, I remember that I can go to this island if I need to turn to the right.
Correct. It's not even that you can, you need to go over those.
Because
if you use the middle lane.
And that's why it was a bit steering, but yeah.
Yeah, so the middle lane said straight ahead only, so you had to go over the hatch markings there in order to get to the right. But I'm talking about just after that, that's where you had your lane discipline. So you did that okay, I was happy with that. It's just when you're coming up to second exit, you should be looking to move back to your left, and you're kind of hesitating, you're going a bit too fast, you're checking your mirrors, but...
I remember that I choose the overtaking exit, like overtaking lane on the exit,
mm-hmm.
because I was staying more than enough, I think, on the right side, on the right lane. So I decided not to harshly, you know, like immediately switch lines on the roundabout, because I know that you can do it only one lane per exit.
Yeah, so we only needed to change one lane there as well, though. Yeah, but you just, I felt like you was going too fast. We're going to keep it simple, okay?
Yeah,
so slow it down a little bit more next time. Give yourself more time. Try to get over.
Yeah.
And if you're not sure, just stay to the overtaking lane. But you did start drifting over and then you move back over.
Yeah.
That's where you got your minor for lane discipline.
Yeah.
And I gave you a minor for junctions turning right. Just felt like it was going too fast, okay?
Yeah, okay.
So you got two minors there. No serious mistakes there. Any other serious mistakes that you think you might have occurred?
When the previous one, parking on my left... I think I touched something on the road.
You touched the curb.
But I looked and it wasn't a curb, but it's maybe it was...
you touched it and it came away.
It was a curb maybe, yeah, but it was a small one, yeah. So yeah. I think this should be a serious mistake.
Okay, so let me talk about that. First of all, there's a parking spot on the left. Now, the area is not massive. It's not big, okay?
Yeah,
so it means we have to come in a bit sharper.
Yeah.
Okay, which is fair. Okay, we have to come in sharper. But when we have to come in sharper, what should your speed be? Fast or slow?
Slow.
Yeah, a little bit slower. Even slower, so you have more time to make sure you don't touch the curb and we can come away.
Yeah, it was a bit rushed because behind me was Mercedes, who actually was always trying to... I don't know, he was trying to overtake me maybe because he was leaning on my right side, so...
Mm-hmm. It's good that you're aware of the cars behind, but as long as we do our mirrors and signal, they should be aware of what you're looking to do. And even if it means we slow right the way down, they should understand that we're trying to go into a tight gap there and we don't want to damage our tires or
mount
the curb and so on. Now, on that occasion, I gave you a minor for that as well, because I felt like we just touched it ever so slightly.
It wasn't in the curb.
And
I was thinking that maybe it's like, you know, a stone or whatever. It's...
Yeah.
Near the curb, yeah.
But it was definitely the curb. Okay, so we definitely touched the curb there.
Yeah.
But I feel like we just touched it ever so slightly, but we could have prevented that had we come in a bit slower, just paying more attention and giving ourselves better judgment with the steering.
Yeah.
In fact, you would have passed that mock test.
Wow.
Okay, so yes, there was no serious mistakes.
Wow.
You got 13 minors.
13?
13.
And this mirrors, maybe.
Okay,
most
so...
Most of them.
Largely. Well, there's... We're going to talk through them now in a second.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
13 minors, some of these are actually advisory, okay? But, you know, I'm a little bit stricter, so that when it comes to your actual test, it's a little bit easier and you're not even making these advisory mistakes as well, okay? So let's quickly whiz through these.
Yeah.
With the pulling over and parking on the right side of the road,
yep.
I was quite happy with that. Just when I finally said, okay, we're going to park on the right side again on the second attempt, you came in a bit quick.
Yep.
Yep. I was like, okay, you're still in control. There's no oncoming cars. You did do your whole mirrors and signal beforehand. Just make sure we don't come in too quick where, you, again, we misjudge the curb and we hit the curb.
And we can keep the curb.
Yeah, okay. But that I didn't give you a minor or anything for. Once that you pulled over and parked, and also try to keep that right signal on while you're stopping as well. Okay? Because it did turn off at one point. As you're still moving, just make sure we keep it on.
Yeah, 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 yeah. I see.
I gave you a minor for your observations. When I told you to reverse back two car lengths, it was good. You were looking around everywhere. Yeah. But now and again, we had to stop for traffic that was passing through.
Yep.
When they had passed through,
I had to make one once again because the situation can change.
Correct.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Yeah, I was checking this one. I think I didn't check the blind spot. My
it was a mixture. Sometimes your blind spot, sometimes mainly the back window. I didn't see you look around again. So just make sure before you move off again that we do a whole check again, because the situation, like you said, can change as well while you're waiting for the
cars. Exactly, that makes sense. Yeah.
So I just gave you a minor few observations there.
Mm-hmm. And one in the beginning was I stalled the car.
Correct.
Actually, that was so, I don't know, I think that, that was a bit hill. So I need to press a bit more the brake pedal and give a bit more biting point, to put a clutch in the biting point, and then releasing like braking pedal, applying the gas, and then
So I mean, we need to hold a foot brake so that the car doesn't roll back first, make sure the biting point's ready, and then give a little bit more gas and a little bit more clutch in order to get the car moving.
Yes, I
felt like we didn't give enough gas, hence why we stalled and we kept
I feel it like we are losing the power and it immediately
correct stopped. And also we're turning at the same time, so it needs even
because the wheels was on
so just there we did stall the car, but we're going to come that's one of the mistakes that you got a minor for, moving off of control. When I got you to do your vehicle check, so when I asked about the back washer,
The car started like slowing down, and I was busy with this stuff, and then I realized that because I saw the stop lights, I started pressing like a braking, but it was not enough because it wasn't like a 2 seconds
correct gap. So the following distance with the car in front was too close. Now, especially if you're about to do something in the car where you're going to take your eyes off the road,
it's safe to do so. Yeah.
Increase the space in front, so you got more time.
Just before I will be doing something.
Adjust your speed so that you got plenty of time. If you take your eyes off the road, at least you're not going to have to suddenly brake really sharp because the car in front's about to brake. Okay, so I give you a minor for that. Gears, sometimes when you're changing down a gear, this is on the roundabout when you're turning right, that exit, when you're changing down, you're putting the clutch down very slowly and the car's juddering. So you're
braking. Yeah.
Now, when you want to change gears, clutch just goes straight down. Don't put it down slowly because you're going to potentially stall if you keep braking.
I see what you're saying. Yeah, definitely. The first one should be quick. Yeah.
Yeah. So as soon as you want the clutch down, straight down. Okay. Yep. Now, this is where you're getting your most amount of minors, steering. Okay.
Okay.
Now, your steering.
One hand. Yeah.
So you're crossing your arms, first of all.
This one, it was maybe two times. And as you said, I can get my hand into my face.
But yes, if the airbag comes off. Incorrect. Yeah. Also, in a roundabout, we just went a little bit wide, again, because we were using one hand to steer. If you use the pull and push, you'll have more control there.
Yeah.
Also, another time, a few times actually, I've seen you, you're driving one hand. Your left hand is resting on your lap here, and we're doing one hand driving. Yeah. You've got to remember the safest way to drive is with both hands on the steering wheel.
Yes, exactly.
It gives us more control of the steering.
Definitely.
Okay.
Yeah.
Another time I gave you a steering fault was when we touched the curve. We already spoke about that.
Yeah.
Moving off safely, when I got you to pull over and park on one occasion, it was a very busy kind of road.
Yep. Yeah, I remember this. I was waiting a lot. Yeah.
When it came to moving off, I can't remember if it was that one or another one, but when it came to moving off, you didn't check your right blind spot again.
Yeah.
Okay, so
I was stick to the my.
Yeah, you're looking window. There and you saw the gap coming up. Just make sure there's nothing in your blind spot in the situation.
Exactly. Definitely. That makes sense. Yeah.
Use the mirrors before signaling on one of the roundabouts. I feel like it was one where we were going straight ahead, second exit. Mm-hmm.
I applied after, I think.
You signaled and then checked your mirrors after. Mirrors, make sure it's safe. Left signal.
Yeah.
Response to traffic lights. Now we went.
It was amber one.
Yes. Now, that light had been green for a very long time.
I had to be prepared to break in.
You should be saying to yourself, these lights could change. So at a certain point, you should be covering your brakes and saying, if these lights change at this point, I'm going to start slowing down. So just covering your brakes. And then if they don't change by that point, back on the gas and we keep going.
But
you're just on the gas.
Yeah. I saw. So it was maybe before roundabout or after.
But that point, it was safe to continue. And it was a good thing we didn't slam on the brakes because it wasn't safe to stop at that point.
Yeah.
But just what I'm trying to say is, anticipate the traffic.
I should start braking a bit like in advance.
I wouldn't have braked. I would have been safe.
Like removing the gas pedal. Yeah.
Come off the gas.
It would be like
if the lights change, we can stop smoothly and safely if it's safe to do so. If not, back on the gas when it's unsafe to stop and we keep going.
Yeah.
But at that point, I feel like we didn't anticipate the lights at all.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Good.
Yep.
And then I gave you the turning right on the junction that was on the roundabout. I felt like we could have gone a bit slower.
Definitely.
Lane discipline. I already spoke about that. Staying in within one lane.
Yeah.
And then normal stops just here at the end. I feel like we'd park too far away from the curb.
Yeah.
Now, when I know you said that, I can reverse back and make it closer. But when the examiners ask you to pull over and park in a safe place,
it doesn't mean they don't want you to reverse.
They just want you to come in and park, okay? And if you try to reverse, they're just gonna say, don't worry about it.
Yeah.
So make sure you can actually position yourself well enough so you don't have to reverse in the first place.
Yeah, I can a bit quickly explain. So definitely I did it like very far away from the car, but I did it because I was trying to understand what I did in the previous pull in the park on the left side, because I literally touched the curb. So I was like talking to myself, what I did wrong. Maybe I need to be a bit far away. Mm-hmm. So it resulted in another.
Yeah, it worked against you.
So I had to like continue and carry on and stop thinking about the previous mistakes.
Exactly. So don't feel like you're going to keep constantly hitting the curb. Like I said before, it was a smaller gap, so we came in sharper.
Yeah.
Now this is a much bigger gap. We've got loads of space behind us, loads of space in front. I know there's nowhere to park in front of us, but we could have used the space behind.
Definitely.
We could have used the space behind to come in a bit better.
Yeah.
And park better here as well.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, sure.
Good. Do you understand all the mistakes?
Yeah. Thank you. And thank you. It's a very good feedback. And it definitely helps me to anticipate next time.
Good.
Yeah.
And
thank you.
If you're passing a mock test on me, I see no reason why you shouldn't pass your actual test as well.
Yeah, I will try.
But very good drive. Like I said, there's really good things in there. I mean, as you can see, you would have passed.
Yeah.
But just work on these little minors, work on steering a little bit more, just to give us better control of the car.
Yeah.
And we should have no problems passing a mock actual test.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
There you go. So people do pass their mock test with me.
Yeah.
Well done to Viktor.
Yeah.
And hopefully he passes his actual test, and we'll let you guys know if he does or not. And we'll see you guys in the next mock test.
Yeah. Okay.